Whoever keeps stealing the lesbian's other half of their eyebrow, I'll have you know, I hear they're really good with scissors. They're gonna cut you up, buddy.
Why do straight people think they need a straight pride parade? Netflix is already paying $100 million to keep Friends on. Isn't that enough? Oh, you're a lesbian? Name three of the women we've both dated. Somewhere, a lesbian couple who's been dating for 2 weeks is putting together a YouTube channel, and you can't do anything to stop them. When I was 10, I remember thinking, it sucks that when you get older, you have to marry a boy. I wish two women could just live forever instead. Proud of myself for never having heard about gay people and independently inventing the concept of lesbians. Anyone else start out as a tomboy and end up as a lesbian? They should open a nightclub for lesbian women and call it G-Spot. No guys will turn up anyways because they won't be able to find it.
And it's not wrong, not my new songs on your playlist. You like gay shit.
Ba-ba-da-da, 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 ba-ba-da-da.
Take a look at my girlfriend. She's the only one I got.
I just came here to the party for the drugs. Drugs, drugs, drugs. I'm not trying to make a friend or fall in love. Love, love, love. So just stop the faking.
Oh, hi everybody. That's too short for aggravation and trouble. I love my granddaughter and her partner, Caitlin. And you should love everybody you know. Don't have aggravation or problems.
Life's
just enjoy
too short.
Life.
Yes.
Life is it's just too... a bowl of cherries.
So I came out to my family last Christmas, and I was actually dating my boyfriend at the time. I broke up with him a week after. And then after that, I moved to the city, and I recently just moved in with my... housemate, her name's Maddie. When I moved in with her, my pop called me, and he was pretty silent during the time. He's a bit like, you know how pops can be a bit like, you know, bigots. But he actually called me and he asked me about Maddie and like just said how she was doing. And then he was like, you know, she's your girlfriend though. You feel free to bring her over to the house. I'd love to meet her. I'd love to get to know her. And I just said like, no, don't worry, Pop. Like, she's just like my housemate. But I will bring my girlfriend over if you want to meet her, which was really sweet. No girlfriend yet, so I can't show my Pop. But like, ladies, my Pop will cook you food. Good at cake and shit.
This is a reenactment of me and the girl who bagged my groceries today. Hi.
Hi.
I really like your style.
Oh, thanks. I like your haircut.
You have a nice day.
Yeah, you too.
And now here's the translation for straight people.
Hi.
Oh, hi, I see that you're gay.
Oh, I also see that you're gay, and I am attracted to you.
Oh, I'm attracted to you too, but I'm definitely not going to ask you out, and I assume you're not going to ask me out.
You know, I'd absolutely love to, but I have so much internalized homophobia that I can only see myself pursuing women as creepy and predatory, so I'm not going to do that.
Oh, well, I hope one day we can stop continuously hurting and disappointing ourselves like this.
Oh, I hope the same thing. You have a nice day.
Be gay, do crime.
Hold the goddamn phone. I figured it out. I know why. Lesbians are at least women in same-sex relationships, you know, with other women, move really quickly because, now listen to this, they don't fucking play games. When you fucking get with a guy, they play hard to get, they make you fucking chase them, they want to da-da-da, they want you to fucking beg. No, bitch, I ain't got fucking energy or time for that. That's why women are better, because they say, they get straight to the fucking point. When you know someone likes you and you know they like the other one, you're like, bet, we like each other, let's coexist together, let's fucking do this shit. I ain't got time to waste, chasing after no stupid boy. Fuck them.
Characters from Barbie movies that are definitely gay.
I'll start with the one I think is most obvious. Nori, from Mermaidia. I'm pretty sure all the characters with blue hair are gay, but she's the best one. Also, Elena, from Fairytopia. Azura, from Fairytopia. Again with the blue hair, but also, watch the movie. Dandelion, from Fairytopia. All of them from Fairytopia. All three of the girls from Barbie and the Diamond Castle. They straight up used those twin boys just to get where they were going. They didn't need them. At least half of the 12 dancing princesses, including Ashlyn, Delia, Edeline, Fallon, Isla, I don't know how to pronounce it, and Janessa, because she collected bugs, no offense. Annika from the Pegasus movie, she got that lesbian bun and everything. Erica from Princess and the Pauper, I think she's bi. Alternatively, the cat from Princess and the Pauper. I have more.
I'll see you after the function.
This is a melody.
Yeah. Oh. Oh.
Well, an autocorrect changes bitch to butch. When you're at the nail salon and they ask why you don't grow your nails out. Girls turn on other girls way too easily. My hands do not read this correctly. Today I had my favorite ever unsolicited queer comment. I was holding hands with my girlfriend and a middle-aged woman with very little English approached us. She smiled, nodded approvingly, said, "Man, it's too heavy." Me, mom, can my friend sleep over? Mom, that's fine if, but no boys. Me, growing up gay. Me, I'm gay, friend. It's okay, just don't fall in love with me. Me. My mom, if you keep up this attitude, no boys will ever like you. Me, oh no. You automatically turn gay if you drink this. What happens if I'm already gay and drink it, though? Gay square.
If you don't wanna see.
Welcome to characters that Disney Channel and Nickelodeon tried to convince us were straight, but definitely weren't. Ryan Evans, probably the most infamous one. Dana from Zoe 101. Nickelodeon really thought we would believe that Jade was straight. Sam Puckett. I don't think I need to explain. Robbie Shapiro. I don't think so. Wendy from Gravity Falls. Dez. Disney Channel never went out of their way to convince us that Stella from Lemonade Mouth was straight, but I'm including her anyway. I feel like Vanessa was trying to convince herself she was straight. And Ellie from the newest Freaky Friday. Yeah, that's right, I watched it, and I am proud.
Mom, I'm moving to America because that's where all the pretty lesbians from TikTok are. And you know what? I've had enough of it. So, love you, bye.
Oh, my girlfriend just told me she's pregnant, but I got my tubes tied a long time ago. Ain't that right? Who the fuck was he?
I'm the Virgin Mary.
We giving birth to Jesus Christ himself.
A little gambling is fun when you're with me.
I love it.
Russian roulette is not the same without a gun.
And baby, when it's love, if it's not rough, it isn't fun.
So I was talking to my straight best friend the other day, and then I told her that I was having trouble sleeping and that I needed to find a top to help me sleep better. And this cutie pie, she's like, I thought you liked sleeping in old t-shirts. Honey, that's so cute.
I'm a flirt. Soon as I see her walk up in the club, I'm a flirt.
Inferno, young gang star, flip the kill switch. Jojo, pose, pose, pose. Jojo, pose, pose, pose. Jojo, pose, pose, pose.
More characters from Australian TV shows that I think are kind of gay. Let's start off with an obvious one, Hector from Mortified. Yes, he was more into Taylor, but we all knew he was gay as hell. Gwen and Courtney from TDI. These three, especially Tuberina over here. Lainey from Grudge Band was obviously more into Corey, but I know she'd be down for it. This guy from Dragon Booster, a closeted gay. Widget from Wow Wow Wobbsy, I just have a feeling. Zero from Invisible Network of Kids, she is definitely a lesbian. Perky from the Pinky and Perky show is obviously a gay theatre nerd. Finn from Stoked. Yeah, yeah, Reef, whatever, but ladies, I know some of you would. Dennis from Kid vs. Cat. Gay. Violet and Primrose. They're not just friends. We be new. Holger from Detention Air. A proud gay. Iris from Ruby Gloom. Don't tell me her Cyclops self wouldn't be checking out Ruby. CC from Rory the Racing Car. I don't know, man, she's just kinda cute. And finally, Nikki from 16. The piercings, the clothing, the hair. Gay.
Ayo. Got my heart broken and had a whole personality change check.
I like the way they run, then fall, then die. I like the way they drop when I'm outside. Bitch, I'm not a heathen, that's a label that they gave me. I don't worship Satan, I'm too evil and he hates me. God cannot save me.
Characters from Australian TV shows that I think are kinda gay. First up is CJ the DJ. She worked in a record store, she does DJ gigs, and of course that hair. Lesbian. Next up is Jenny Ten from Dex Hamilton's Alien Entomologist. Blue hair. Lesbian. I'm on the fence about this one. But possibly. Atlanta from Class of the Titans. She's a lesbian and you can't tell me any different. Debbie Thornberry from The Wild Thornberries. That is a stoner and a lesbian. Fly from Blue Water High. I know she had her whole thing with Heath, but you can't tell me that she's not at least bi. This bitch from the Rubber Dubbers. Fucking Little Miss Whoops and Little Miss Daredevil. That's a bottom and a top if I've ever seen it.
Some of us are actually pretty talented. Not all of us go walking around. What's up, BB girl? You guys just don't give us that attention.
Remember how the stars hold the night away.
Hey fams, guess what? Not only am I cute, funny, and smart, but I also do eyelash extensions. You're welcome.
Mommy baby.
You're what?
I'm mommy baby.
You're my baby?
Yes. And I'm fucking cute.
Okay, riddle me this. If I have a baby face, why can't I suck titties in public? Oh, you look like a little baby. Yeah, I look like a little baby. Give me your boobies.
I will sit here and say, actually, I'm proud of myself today. And I am proud of myself today.
Yeah, you should be.
Your pussy's so good, had to save that shit for later. Took her to the kitchen, fucked her right there on the table.
So, about a year ago, I went home from college to visit my family. On a Monday, I was complaining to my mom about how me and my girlfriend were fighting, and I was really upset, very mad. Tuesday, everything's better, and my girlfriend comes over for sexy time. Wednesday, my mom asked me, who was over last night? To which I said, no one. She asked me again, who was over last night? The guest bedroom bed was disheveled. I go, oh, no one. I was just relaxing in there, you know. She goes, well, that's interesting because I heard someone with you. So at this point, I decide to come clean. So I go, well, Paige was over. She goes, sounds like you two are getting along a lot better.
When I first came out of the closet, I used to hate the word lesbian. I would say, I'm gay. Don't call me a lesbian, I'm gay. But now I realize I don't actually hate the word lesbian. I just hate the connotation that's connected with the word lesbian because of the way that we've been represented in the media. And that's on Hollywood. But if we don't start taking the word back and showing people what a lesbian actually is or can be, then that word is gonna keep scaring little baby gays like forever. So I'm a lesbian. And that word is not bad. It's good, okay? Okay.
So if you're even a little bit gay, you probably want to see a lesbian bachelorette. And I mean, like, same. Like, I want to see that. But let's be honest. We already know how the season would go. So yeah, night one, they're coming out of the limos. They're all looking good. They're all into the bachelorette, whatever, whatever. By the end of the episode, we're already hearing them start to talk about each other, how hot they're looking, how cute they're looking. By week two, we already have some of the girls that are supposed to be competing for the bachelorette leave the show to be with each other. By week three, there's only four girls left, so they go right into hometowns. On one of the hometown dates, one girl's ex shows up. She leaves with her. And then another one gets kicked off because she was just trying to get social media influence, and all she really ever wanted was a third for her and her boyfriend. Then we're down to the final two. The bachelorette is in deep contemplation of who she wants to propose to. Chris Harrison comes out and says, your ex just showed up. After a long monologue about how much she screwed up and how much she loves her, the bachelorette gets down on one knee and proposes to the ex. The other two finalists are now living together with a cat.
Because I hate doing shit and not perfecting it. Can you guys hear me good? Big boobs. What? Chill. Anyway, so.
I love it when people come up to me and they're like, what? You're gay? I never knew that. You look so straight. Actually, no one has ever said that to me because I look like a raging lesbian.
I don't know what she was thinking, I know what I wanna see. Bust that pussy open, then I tell her bring it back. Bust that pussy open, then I...
Polar opposite friends check.
So put your...